Alright, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to you. I'm back again. My name is Promise Bill from Promas Recording Studios. I want to show you quickly, this is a very quick tutorial on how to switch between tempos, maybe from 4/4 to 6/8, but you can use any other time signature to do your demonstration. So without wasting time, let me just show you quickly. I'm going to be using additive drums for this tutorial. So I'm playing on a tempo of 120, and this is a preset from additive drums. So I just open my additive drums, come over to beats. In case you are on kits, just switch over to beats, scroll down, you will see numerous presets that you can choose from, or beat patterns, or you can come over to this angle. You can see reggae here, you can see blues. Let's assume I want to work with reggae. I'll just come over here, pick any of the reggae beats, drag it, or just test it first. You can hear the sound. So in case you want to do adjustment to it, just go over to transform. You can choose to increase any of the instrument. Once you are satisfied, you can drag it over to your timeline and you stop this one. So this is a 4/4 time signature. You can see it's a bit very slow. So what I will do first, Ctrl T on my keyboard to take me to my tempo track. Then you see this little knob here, you can push it up and the tempo will keep increasing to the point that you want it to be. So let's try 140. Okay, this is 150. Alright, now we've gotten our tempo on 4/4 beat signature or time signature. And let's say at this point, at this fifth bar, I want it to switch to 6/8, any 6/8 kind of beat. So what will I do? I will take my cursor to this point, this fifth bar. Then I'll press Ctrl T again, take me to my tempo track, as you can see, expanding the beat. Then I will come over here and create another point. You can just right click on the point. You can see it will move. So I've created the point, but before I do that, I will come over here and I will copy this time signature. Follow me closely. I will copy this time signature, Ctrl C. Make sure your cursor is on the point where you want to switch the timing and paste it there. You can see. After doing that, double click it and write 6/8 or any other time signature that you wish to change it to. If you look at this point, you will see that the lines are different from this point. But if I expand it a bit, you see. Look at it. So in between here, we have four counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see it. Makes a 4/4 bar. In between this, we have 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So what do I do lastly? I will go back to my little drums and look for a 6/8 kind of beat. This is to quicken the tutorial so that I will not waste too much time, but you can sequence your own beats. I will just come over here and type 6/8. Alright. Let me go with this. So I will drag it to the point where my 6/8 time signature starts. Then I will stop the beat, so I will test it to know if I'm on track. So it's a bit too fast, so I will take the cursor back to this point. Don't forget, always on the first point where the whole thing starts. Then I will click my Ctrl T again, come back, open this place a bit, come over to this point. You see this dot that you created here? Drag it a bit down to the point where you are okay. Fantastic. So at this point, let's play everything together now. You can visually see the maturity and the synchronization of the two beat signature. The tempo should not be far apart or too different from each other, you understand? So when you're doing that, please check your tempo, check your time signature, and do a better job. So this is what we'll call it off on this tutorial today. If it has been a blessing to you, please click the subscribe button and don't forget to share, like, and comment. Thank you. I remain Promise Bill.